These are the new Hako-Forge cases. Here we have the Core, and this is the Core Mini. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Core. This build here is configured for the highest hard drive density, 42 hard drives, 6 SSDs. Now I say configured because the Hako-Core system can actually be customized. The Core supports 9 standard backplanes and 3 small backplanes. These can be mixed and matched in almost any way to meet your own needs. Currently for the standard backplanes, we have the 4 hard drive and 12 SSD. And for the small backplane, we have the 2 hard drive, 2 SSD, or the 2 plus 2 as we like to call it. These boards convert the 12 volts from your power supply into the 5 volts needed for your drives right on the board. This way, the 5 volt rail, which is usually insufficient for this number of drives anyway, it's never used. To break out the 12 volts from the power supply, we have our power board.
It takes 4 of the PCIe power cables and distributes them to the backplanes. There are fan headers that can be controlled by a header on your motherboard, or we'll have a container app that will allow you to control your fans as well as monitor the power usage of your drives. Speaking of fans, the Core supports 3 rows of 120mm fans and an 80 or 92mm exhaust fan. With our newest revision, we've also added auxiliary fan mounts to help you cool your PCIe cards that don't have their own cooling already.
Here we have it in its boxed form, but it is a server and you can mount server rails on it. On our store, we have toolless ball bearing rails that you can add on as an accessory. With the Core Mini, it's just a more compact version of the Core. We have 2 rows of fans and 2 rows of backplanes.
In its highest hard drive density configuration, you can have 28 hard drives and 4 SSDs. If you plan on using an eATX motherboard, the second row will only be able to do 1 standard or small backplane.
Other than the differences in layout, every other feature is exactly the same. You still have your auxiliary fan mounts, your exhaust fan mount, and it can be mounted in a server rack. So that was an overview of the Hako-Core and the Hako-Core Mini. Go down in the comments and let us know your thoughts. Follow us on our socials and on our Discord. We do have a good community going on right there if you have any questions, not just about the Hako-Core stuff, home labbing and server stuff in general. Like and subscribe. We'll be doing a video on the Hako-Core, fully populated drives, motherboard, graphics card, something crazy.
Check the description for 10% off your order at hakoforge.com.